Okay, so pennants are really great for representing collections that are powers of two in size. But a bag needs to be able to contain any number of elements, so how can we use pennants in order to build bags? And it turns out, a basic idea from computer science preschool is what is going to help us. First, I want you to remember a basic fact about binary arithmetic. In particular, you can represent any non-negative integer as a binary string. So let's take an integer, I don't know, how about 23? How do you write this in binary? The answer is 10111 in base 2. Now each bit position represents a distinct power of 2, so let's number the bit positions. So this bit is 2 to the 0, which is equal to 1. The second bit is 2 to the 1, or 2. And we can go on and on and on. And notice that 16 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1 is 23. Okay, so what does this have to do with bags? Here's a collection of 23 elements, and let's say I want to throw them into a bag. How do I do it? Here's an idea. Let's use pennants. So you can see what I've done here. In the same way that you can take the integer 23 and write it as a series or a sequence of powers of 2, I've taken the items in the collection and I've grouped them into powers of 2. Now I'm going to need to connect these in some way. So to do that, I'm going to use an array of pointers to the roots of each pennant. And I'll use a null pointer for the empty bit. Now this array, I'm going to give a special name. I'm going to call it a spine. So just as a brief recap, I've taken my collection of elements, I've broken it up into these power of two sized pennants, and I've connected them together with this thing that I'm calling a spine.